Welcome back to Queen, the Greatest, a celebration of 50 of the greatest moments from the Queen story so far. Here I stand, here I stand, looking around, around, around. In this film, we head back to 1974 to revisit some landmark gigs in which Queen were able to follow in the footsteps of some of their heroes. Promoter Mel Bush had seen what Queen were capable of on stage in 1973 when he had included them as the support act for the Mott the Hoople tour. Not only was he convinced Queen were ready to headline their own tour, but they could also fill a venue as prestigious as the Rainbow. Having played host to acts such as Jimi Hendrix, The Beach Boys, David Bowie and Eric Clapton, for a young band like Queen, headlining at the Rainbow really was the stuff of dreams. A dream that came true on their Queen 2 tour on the 31st of March 1974.
How long did that album take then altogether?
Well, it took about 3.5 months, which in those days was an epic. That album was the first sort of aesthetic nervous breakdown producer that we'd had, because we worked all hours for months. It was the first sort of mammoth job we did. You know, we went about triple the budget that we were originally allowed. But because I think the record company and the production company were pretty sympathetic artistically at that time, and they kept hearing bits and saying, it's great, you know, okay, go on. Anyway, once you're halfway through, they can't really get you to stop. You know? They want an album.
We'd done our support tour, and then Mel Bush came to us. He was a pretty top promoter at the time, and he said, I think you guys can headline the next tour. And we were surprised. I remember thinking, wow, that's very quick, because normally you would support a few acts and build a following, and then you would go on your headline tour. But he said, no, I feel you can do it. You can sell out all these places. And he gave us a big list. Newcastle City Hall, Manchester Free Trade, or whatever, you know, all the sort of classic gigs that rock bands do. And he said, you can fill all these. And at the end, we're going to do the Rainbow.
In October 1974, when the band embarked on their next UK tour to promote the Sheer Heart Attack album, it was no surprise that the Rainbow would again feature on their tour schedule. However, this time, due to overwhelming demand, a second night had to be added. A ticket to this sought-after gig would have set you back £1.75. These spectacular nights at the Rainbow in 1974 were a clear statement that, as a live act in the UK, Queen had well and truly arrived.